Welcome to My American Friend. You can find us on www.myamericanfriendblog.com. Marta's Road Book, number 5. Rome, the fountains.
This is what Italy is famous for: history and art.
And food, of course. Visiting Rome is a never-ending experience. Not even 10 days in a row would be enough to see half of it. Rome has been the capital of the Roman Empire first and of the Christian world later on. And it wouldn't have been possible without one precious element: water. Some water-related words you need to know when visiting the Eternal City are aqueducts, the waterway system providing Rome with running water; baths, public facilities for bathing and wellness; monumental fountains, beautiful fountains decorating Rome and still glorifying who built them. The Trevi Fountain is maybe the most famous of all. It's been the setting of films like La Dolce Vita and Roman Holidays. There's a popular superstition about it. By throwing a coin in the Trevi Fountain, you are ensured to return to Rome. Every single day, about 3,000 euro are thrown in that fountain, then collected for charity. There are so many fountains in Rome that you can decide to follow an itinerary across the center to see them all, possibly by night. Don't miss the famous fountains in Piazza Navona, Piazza di Spagna, and in front of the Pantheon. But this is just the beginning. Be ready to discover a lot of minor fountains that embellish every hidden corner of Rome.
This is Nasone. It means big nose. Big nose.
There are so many of these little drinking fountains around you. They are not monumental, but they are very useful. The water is always fresh, good, and for free. Okay, that's it for now. Come visit us on www.myamericanfriendblog.com and listen to our podcast as well. Thank you very much. I'll see you soon. Bye. My American Friend.